Hey guys, it's Lance at Max Sound Solutions, and after Apple announced today their M2 Pro offerings, I just thought we'd go through and have a look and see what you can get sort of at the exact same price. So I set up three computers, all of them cost $2,199, and I just wanted to see sort of where they land. Apple makes it pretty confusing these days with CPU cores, GPU cores, neural engine cores, and so forth. So let's see what we get for $2,199. So starting with the MacBook Pro, we got a 10-core CPU, 16-core GPU, and a 16-core neural engine. They all have 16-core neural engines, so I'm not going to repeat that. But we only get 16 gigs of RAM at this price, and they all have 1 terabyte of storage. But the RAM is where it kind of differs, and the amount of cores. Now we'll move over to the Mac Mini. The Mac Mini has 2 more cores. It's got 12-core CPU. It's got 3 more cores on the GPU, and same neural engine. But we get 32 gigs of RAM, so twice the amount of RAM. Apple charges you $400 for that extra 16 gigs. Ouch, that's a lot. But of course, with the Mac Mini, you're not getting a screen, you're not getting a keyboard, you're not getting a trackpad. But you are getting more ports, and we'll go over the ports in a minute. Now on to the Mac Studio M1 Max. You're getting a 10-core CPU, a 24-core GPU, and a 16-core neural engine, same as the others. So you're getting 2 less cores on the CPU, and you're getting 5 more cores on the GPU. But it's an M1 Max, it's not an M2 Pro. So here's a quick summary on the three computers. And obviously the Mac Mini M2 Pro is going to outperform the MacBook Pro. And I would think the Mac Studio would outperform the Mac Mini. Maybe not by a lot. So before we talk about the ports on each computer, I want to talk about monitor connectivity. So first we'll start with the MacBook Pro. The M2 Pro version supports up to 2 external displays with up to 6K resolution at 60 Hz over Thunderbolt, or 1 external display with up to 6K resolution at 60 Hz over Thunderbolt, and 1 external display with up to 4K resolution at 144 Hz over HDMI. Now, I believe this is the first time you have that high of a refresh rate at 4K resolution. And then the last one, 1 external display supported at 8K resolution at 60 Hz, or, and this is the clincher, 1 external display at 4K resolution at 240 Hz over HDMI. And that is a first for any Mac, I believe, except for maybe the older Mac Pro with a dedicated graphics card. And now looking at the Mac Mini M2 Pro, you can run 3 displays, 2 via Thunderbolt at 6K 60 Hz and 1 via HDMI 4K at 60 Hz. Then you can also have 2 displays, 1 at 6K via Thunderbolt at 60 Hz and 1 at 4K via HDMI at 144 Hz. So basically, you know, the MacBook Pro has its own screen, so you're limited to that resolution plus the other 2 monitors. And this does the same 1 display thing, which is 8K at 60 Hz via Thunderbolt or 4K at 240 Hz via HDMI. So the only difference is you can have 3 monitors with the Mac Mini, and the MacBook Pro, you can only have the built-in MacBook Pro display and 2 external displays. And here we have the Mac Studio with the M1 Max chip, which can run up to 5 displays at once. Pretty impressive. But it cannot do high refresh rates at 4K. It can do it at 2K. It can run monitors at 140 at 2K. But it cannot do it at 4K. So the newer M2 Pro chips are able to do higher refresh rates than the M1 Max in the Mac Studio. So here are some interesting specs I found on a website. And, you know, Apple pretty much hides what megahertz these computers run at. You know, they always say more cores, it's faster, but they don't show you the megahertz anymore. And when you look at this, you can see at the top here, let's just go through these, the clock speed on the M1 Max is up to 3.2 megahertz, and the M2 Pro is up to 3.4 megahertz, and the lower clock speeds are also faster. So 2.0 on the Max and 2.4 on the M2 Pro. Then you look at the caches. You get a little more L1 cache on the M2 Pro. You get L2 cache, you get more, but the L3 cache, you get less. I don't know if that's because the one they have listed here has 32-core GPU, and of course I selected the 24-core GPU. This is a pretty cool website I stumbled on, notebookcheck.net, and you can bring up different CPU models and compare them, and then they also have a bunch of benchmarks, but seeing the M2 Pro has just come out, I don't think there's benchmarks for that yet. On Apple's website, they have this little graph and showing faster ProRes transcoding performance in Final Cut Pro. But it shows that the M2 Max is at the top of the food chain there, and that the M2 Pro is actually slower than the M1 Max. So the Mac Mini will probably render video a little slower than the M1 Max does in the Mac Pro Studio. But of course, Apple doesn't show how many GPU cores are in these computers. So we'll have to wait and see for people to get these M2 Pros in their hands and run some benchmarks to compare it to the M1 Max. So now let's look at the ports available on each computer. With the MacBook Pro, you get 3 Thunderbolt 4 ports, an HDMI, and an SDXC card reader. On the Mac Mini, you get 4 Thunderbolt 4 ports, HDMI, 2 USB-A ports, and an Ethernet port, which I love. I wish the MacBook Pro had that. You do not get an SDXC card reader. And then the Mac Studio has the most ports with 4 Thunderbolt 4s on the back. Now I'm talking the M1 Max, not the Ultra. 4 Thunderbolt 4s on the back, Ethernet, basically all the same ports that the Mac Mini has on the back. And in the front, it's got additional 2 USB-C ports and SDXC card reader. And obviously by looking at these two computers, the Mac Studio is going to run cooler. It's mainly a giant fan in there. So obviously the Mac Mini is going to run hotter, and it's probably going to throttle sooner when you're really taxing the computer. So that's something to consider. So this looks like a good deal. I don't get any kickback from this, but if you go to the Apple refurbished store, you can buy refurbished Macs. You get the same warranty as a brand new Mac. Here's the Mac Studio. Now this has only got 512 gigs of storage. It doesn't have the 1 terabyte, but it's $1,800. That's a pretty good price. And I know the MacBook Pros, you can also get a decent deal on them. Obviously the new M2 computers are not on the refurbished store yet. The other thing is to consider is the Mac Studio is going to be upgraded very soon to be M2. So there's that. But they might be a little more pricey. I think this is a good deal. I think the Mac Studio is the winner out of all of these. Maybe it's slightly slower in performance on certain things than the M2 Pro, but my guess is because of the better thermals and you get more ports and an SD card reader, an Ethernet port, and 2 more USB-C ports. You know, I think this is the way to go. If I were to buy one of these computers, I'd be buying the Mac Studio. So I know this was a long droning video. My daughter's asleep. I didn't want to make a bunch of noise, but thanks for listening, watching, and please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you on the next Mac Sound Solutions video.